Hey YouTube, thanks for stopping by. I'm Mike Wilcoxon with One Click Away, and today I got some beginner's tips on how to get started investing. Let's go. Now, getting started with investing can be pretty intimidating. It always seems like there's so much you gotta know before you get started, just so you don't lose any money. Well, as a beginner investor, I mean, chances are decent that you're gonna lose some money, probably a small amount, if you listen to me and invest safely and conservatively. So what I recommend doing, if you haven't already, download the Robinhood app. It's great for beginners. Use the link in the description. And that way, when you sign up using my referral link, you'll also get a free stock. So when you download the app, if you're not ready to buy any stocks yet, you'll have a free stock that you can watch. You can see it go up and down and get familiar with how it works, the fluctuations, and what Robinhood has to offer. Now, just know that I'm not a paid or accredited financial advisor. I don't work for Robinhood or anybody else. I just do this because I like doing it. I'm trying to reach out to people, especially young people who haven't started investing yet and want to get started, know that it's a good idea, but just aren't sure how. You got to get started early in order to make any kind of money, and especially in the investment strategy that I do, that I'm about to talk to you about. Make sure that you trust the person that is giving you any kind of financial advice. Okay, I'm not saying that you should trust me, but I am saying that I have been doing this for a little while. I've been doing a lot of studying, and I'm just a regular guy, but it's been working for me. And what I do is I have a very safe, conservative investment strategy. It's a strategy that capitalizes on long-term positions, and instead of investing into individual stocks, I invest in what's called ETFs, or exchange-traded funds. And what ETFs are, is picture them like a giant portfolio of a bunch of different companies' stocks within it. So there's ETFs for everything. One of the examples I like to use the best is the ETF VOO, okay? And that's a Vanguard ETF, and it tracks the S&P 500 in the United States. So it's the S&P market, which is the top 500 companies in the entire United States. So VOO, just like any other stock or ETF, has a share price, okay? And that share price fluctuates and goes up and down based on how the average of the 500 companies inside of the fund do. So you can imagine the average of 500 companies, if you had to do that kind of math, it really doesn't fluctuate all that much just because there's so many. But what it does do is it steadily increases over time. So if you look at a chart of the S&P 500 over the last, 50 years, you'll see that it generally goes up in a gradual straight line. You can see, like any stock chart, you can see ups and downs, but they're very minimal, and they do continue to go up in a general incline. If you look at an individual stock chart throughout the history of that stock, those share prices fluctuate much more because those share prices are an average of, let's say, 500 companies. It's only how that one company performs in and of itself. So that's why I like ETFs, because ETFs have a lot of different stocks in it. They're safer, the share price doesn't fluctuate as much, and they're much better for long-term investments. Now, the S&P 500, going back, has a general average rate of return of about 10% per year. Now, of course, it's not always 10%, but you know, sometimes it could be 12%, sometimes it's negative 3% on the year, sometimes it's 26, 27%. Just in general, on average, it's about 10% per year. So that makes it really easy to do the mathematical projections on how much money that you would have based on your initial investment over a span of 20, 30, 40 years. I like this strategy because it's a safe strategy. It's one that is tried and true. And it's also endorsed by Warren Buffett. Now, this type of investing strategy is for the lazy investor. the passive investor, because literally all you have to do is contribute a regular amount of money to, you know, a big ETF like this, or a couple of big ETFs that are similar. There's also ones that track, you know, the entire stock market, the entire international stock market. There's also ETFs that are categorical, like invest in something that tracks all the cannabis stocks, or all of the medical stocks, or something like that. Robotics, genomics, you name it, there's an ETF for that. ETFs are great for the passive investor, where you can basically just set it and forget it. And that's a style that I like, because I don't have the time every day to be on my phone looking at Robinhood or any other investment app and constantly making changes based on how the market is looking that day. And if you do that and you trade every day, that you can be considered a day trader, which is someone who buys a stock, a stock position earlier in the day and sells it the same day. Or you could be a swing trader, which is when someone buys a stock one day and holds on to it for a little longer period of time. Maybe it's days, weeks, months, and then sells it. All right. I like the long-term investing strategy because I know that it works. This type of strategy is ideal for beginner investors. Before we go check out the four ETFs I talked about, let's first look at the 20-year historical S&P 500 chart. So as I mentioned before, you can see that there are a series of peaks and valleys, but in general, if you started investing in the S&P 500 20 years ago in the year 2000, and then you look at where we are now in the year 2021, there's a huge increase in how the S&P 500 is doing. So you could pretty much figure out that your investment will have increased over the period of 20 years steadily. Here's a chart of the Vanguard S&P 500 ETF, also called VOO. You can see that the chart looks very similar to the actual S&P 500. Going all the way back, this is to 2011, all the way to 2021. This is a 10-year chart, and you can see that there's a steady increase in the value of this particular ETF. All right, this is the chart for the Vanguard Total Stock Market Index Fund, VTI. Okay, so this one is the Vanguard ETF that tracks the total stock market. That means NASDAQ, S&P 500, and the Dow Jones Industrial Average. As you can see, it looks very similar to both of the other charts so far. The only difference is this one, in addition to tracking the S&P 500, it also tracks the other two, the NASDAQ and the Dow Jones. This one's a little different. This is the Vanguard Total International Stock Index Fund ETF. So this tracks international stock markets all over the world. I think it's the entire world stock market averaged in here. So it looks a little bit different than just the United States' S&P 500 and Dow Jones and NASDAQ. It has way more peaks and valleys. This is the Vanguard Dividend Appreciation Index Fund. This one looks a lot like all the other U.S. charts that we looked at before. Again, going back to 2011, it's a steady increase all the way until 2021 with some punctuated valleys there, as you can see. But generally, over the span of 10 years in this case, you can see that it's a pretty much a constant upwards positive pattern. Hey guys, I know that was a little dry with the charts, but I just wanted you to see that if you start investing early and often, that you're almost definitely guaranteed to turn a profit, okay? It's really not hard. It's a great way to invest. I highly, 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 highly recommend that style of investing. Pick a big fund or two, whatever combination of the big, huge funds that you want, and start investing. The earlier you start investing, the more money you're going to make. Please do not wait. Any little bit, it helps. Trust me. Okay. Please, please do not day trade. It seems fun. You know, I'm sure you see things on maybe like Wall Street Bets, or your friends are talking about these one or two individual stocks that are hot stocks right now. And yeah, maybe they can make some money and maybe you could too, but I highly recommend if you're going to do that, use a very tiny percentage of your portfolio. Use a larger percent, you know, 80, 90%, and put it in these big funds, because I'm telling you, that is the way to go. That is the safe way and the smart way. Okay. So, hey, if you like this video and you got some value out of it, please hit the like button, subscribe, Leave me a comment. Hit the notification bell. Let me know what you thought about the video. Let me know if you have any ideas for me so I can make another video and continue making fresh quality content for you. And I just want you guys to, you know, start to get financially woke and start investing for your future, because you owe it to yourself. And for those of you who have families, you owe it to them too. All right. Hey, I'm Mike Wilcoxon from One Click Away. And remember, you might only be one click away from learning something brand new that could fundamentally change your financial future for the better. Okay? So thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time.